I'm Scott Jacobs, and this is Simply Mauvelous. I have to say that with a slight accent because when Lucy came up with the title for the piece, that's how she said it to me. And I laughed at first, and I think it actually is a great title. This particular piece is one of my newest flower pieces, a rose, which I've painted many, many times. It's a combination of a acrylic painting and an oil painting. I did the oil up here and the actual flower itself, and everything else was done in acrylic. It is reminiscent of a piece I did about 20 years ago called Dolce. And the thing that was interesting about Dolce is that I was doing this light colored flower, a rose, in front of a light background, similar to this here. And I didn't think that the flower would stand out off of the light background really well. So what I did was I dissected the background with an angle like this. And so I got the idea from Dolce and did it again on this piece. So you can see how the darker section in the upper right actually really sets off the rose against the dark background. What I think makes this piece unique, not only the two-tone background that really makes the rose pop off, is the simplicity of the vase. There's no water in it. It's obviously somebody went in the backyard maybe and cut it off of their rose bush and just brought it in to set it there for a minute. Maybe they're gonna trim a couple of foliage off of it and cut the stem down, put it in another vase. I did one piece that I thought was really funny. It was two flowers. It was a small vase like this, and there was a flower in it that was, you know, maybe half the size of the bottle sticking out the top. And then laying over here was a stem curled up, and this flower was looking down. So it looked like this flower was looking down at the other flower. There was water in the vase, so I called it Need a Drink, because it was like this other flower crawled over the vase and was saying, hey, I need a drink. Yeah, I have fun with some of these. I mean, these are a lot of fun to do. If you look at the rose, there are so many colors that are reflected in the rose. There's reds and yellows, and it's like painting flesh. You know, what is flesh? Flesh isn't just flesh color. There's greens, there's pinks, there's all kinds of reflected light in the surface of skin tone. Same thing with the flower. Whether it's a red flower, a pink flower, a white flower, there are so many different tones in it. So it's very challenging. You know, me as a photorealist, I'm trying to challenge myself with everything I do. And maybe somebody would say, oh, the flower is so much easier than painting chrome. Yeah, maybe to an extent. But if you really get into the piece, if you look at the foliage on it, the leaves, there's a ton of work in these leaves. You've got all these variegated areas, and it's almost like you're painting all these little paintings in between all the veins. It's a lot more difficult than what the eye sees. I hope people love this, of course, you know, because I loved painting it. You know, you get this vision as an artist in your head, and then you draw it out on paper, and then you're excited through the entire process of painting it. And then you hope that somebody loves it enough to not only buy the original, which just actually sold in South Africa, but to buy the print. You know, because there's a lot of artists in the world, and we're all looking for that space in everyone's home on the wall. And so for somebody to say, I'm taking this home, I'm putting this on that space in my living room or whatever it is a huge compliment to an artist. So I'm hoping that people feel the same way about this piece that I did painting.